that concludes my presentation on why white people love Cordura.
This is a pretty great party, man.
Yeah, it's okay. I don't know. It's kind of a sausage fest.
Really? What about that cute little green number over there on the couch?
You mean the pillow?
Get out of here, man. You are cramping my style. Is this seat taken? I'm Steve. Nice to meet you. You here with anyone? Oh, him? No, he's a friend of mine from college. You can say that again. I noticed that you don't have an adult beverage over here. Would you like me to go grab you one? Great, I'll be right back, hon. Cup of vino for my lady. So, you want to get out of here? Your place or mine? Sounds good to me. Let's go.
I think he just stole your pillow.
Was that as good for you as it was for me?
It's been the best day of my life. I love you.
Shh.
You don't have to say anything.
Where are you? Aww.
Hello, I'm home. What's going on, hon? What's going on here? You in bed with my own satin pillow? In my own bed? I thought we were in love! And you just threw it all away!
Corduroy Club is a dynamic, powerful, and influential organization that will change your life. Join today.
Buenas noches, señora. ¿Dónde está mi corduroy?
How did you end up on the streets?
Well, I was in my third year as a creative writing professor at Sarah Lawrence, and everything seemed to be going really well. But they told me that I wasn't going to be considered for a tenure-track position, and after that, I just kind of fell apart for a little bit.
So what happened after you left Bronxville?
Well, I wandered for a little bit, kind of lost, and didn't really know what to do, and I ended up drifting down towards the city. Tried to get a position at Columbia, the new school, but nobody seemed to want to have me, and I ended up out on the streets by myself, and it's amazing how fast you find yourself hitting rock bottom, doing things you never thought you could, and things that you never thought were even possible. before too long, to keep my old habits up, I was visiting bootleg tailors down on Canal Street, trying to find any piece of corduroy I could, because who wants to hire an English professor who's not wearing corduroy? It doesn't make any sense.
Hey, you need anything?
Hey, man.
Yeah, what do you got?
Take a look, man.
Oh, man, I don't want any of that kid stuff.
Yeah?
I know what you need. Come with me.
But it wasn't long before Lloyd, desperate and lonely, in a city that didn't care about him, or post-war modernists, hit rock bottom.
It's a story as old as the world. Young academic comes to the city, fresh-faced, full of hope, a 400-page dissertation in his pocket on the liturgical symbolism and gravity's rainbow. Before too long, he's out there hustling, writing dissertations on Twilight and essays deconstructing the Real Housewives of Jersey on the street just to make ends meet. Oh, they all think they can keep it under control, that they can wear corduroy as a style. Just for a laugh, all their friends are doing it. One more squared off tie isn't gonna make a difference, but before too long, they fall into a spiral. Corduroy just isn't enough anymore. They don't make one with a whale wide enough to satisfy anyone. Soon they're scoring harder fabrics. Tweed, denim, who knows what else. Before they know it, they're in too deep. They can't get it out. Looking for anything they can get their hands on 39th Street.
We all know I got what they need. And when they're ready, I move them up to the hottest stuff. We all know that snakeskin is nature's corduroy, baby.
I've been doing better. I'm getting my life back together. I joined a 12-step program, and it's been really helping me fight off the urges. It's only difficult when I have to walk past a thrift store, one of those fabric stores, because I know what's inside, but one day at a time.
J'adore corduroy.